Okay, so here we are. We're back in Omarchy, and we're going to set it up to use well, for a creative, because it's obviously very steered towards developers, which is fine. Which is fine. The people, David, who did this, David Henneman. I'm sorry, I keep doing the name wrong, but David, he's a developer. So it's basically create his order. We have to tweak this, which is great. It gives you the foundation, and tweak it and put it into a more for creative tools. Okay, so how do you install applications? That's the first part. Now, there's a prerequisite to this. I've already pre-installed DaVinci Resolve on here using the script that I wrote that's in another video. I'll flash up the link to that video. So, because part of this is working out how to do key bindings. Anyway, so let's install some software. So, super alt space, and then you go to install. Now, you've got a lot of stuff on here already. You've got OBS, stuff like that, but you want, you know, the generics. You need the generics to work, so you need your Photoshop stuff. So let's do package, and all you need to do is type in GIMP, press enter, GIMP will install. The next one you would need, like audio, you could do Audacity, there it is. Select that, enter it. Blender, there it is. And basically, you can just literally bash through this in a few minutes and get a really good suite of software on there. So let's get rid of that. And let's just bring that back up again. Okay, so you've got your apps. And if you go through, put Audacity on there, Blender, and just installs, press return, finds up, and we're in Blender. So general, there we go. And then Alt-W, back out of it. Super keys back in, apps. And then we've got the audio editor, Audacity, tweak your WAV files. Come out of that. Same again. Apps, what else did I put on here? Blender, Bluetooth. Now you've got GIMP. I mean, obviously I'm just tapping through it, but you can just type that at the top. Then you've got GIMP ready to go, close. W, come out of that. So you see, you know, GIMP, and what else did I put on here? GIMP. Photopea. Now this is interesting. Now in all my other Linux videos I talk about, you can use GIMP, but there's a thing called Photopea, which is an online online Photoshop equivalent. So let's just show you how to set that up quickly. I've already done it, but it's quite simple. So let's come out of this. Let's come out of that. And then we just go to Super B, brings up our browser. And then we just go to Photopea, which is here. Now, when this loads in, you'll get a little icon up here to install it as a web app. And then basically it becomes a web app on your desktop. Really simple. Now, you get the paid version, they don't get the advertising. So if I now go to space apps, photo P and launch it, it's now become an app. So I'll still get my advertising over here, new project, but I'm working on obviously up in the cloud or whatever I'm doing to use it. Insta story, and there we go. So just come out of that. So my software is installed. I can't think of anything else you might need. Darktable. Actually, I could install Darktable because I haven't installed it on this yet. So let's do that. So let's go to install package. See what's on here. Darktable. There you go. This is how simple it is. Press return password. Now, I've used lots of these package managers, and it's just like mind-boggling on how to do it, and it's done. Come back out of it, go to apps, go to dark. There it is, dark table, and off it goes, setting up table tags. Wait, this is going to crash now, isn't it, for me? Is he going to do it? I haven't tried this on here. I think you can do RawTherapee as well. Let's come out of that and try again. Let's try. So, Darktable. Maybe it's try the AUR version. I might try that again then. Let's just see if we can get it to work. Darktable. Application not responding. Terminate. Oh, no, it's done it. It's done it. Okay. it did this, it does this a couple of times and some stuff, it sort of can't get there the first time it does it. So now we're good. Don't know why it did that. Darktable, dark room. Let's come out, try and run it again. Apps, Darktable. Loading processing modules. I think I have to wait. No, just leave it and it does its thing. There you go. That could be the app itself. Probably not. Don't know. Anyway, so there you go. So you can install. Let's try RawTherapee. I think that's a Linux app, isn't it? So install package Raw. There is. Quality. So your photos developing RAWs and stuff like that. Can pull it down. Done. Get back into my thingy. Apps, Raw. That runs. There you go. There's RawTherapee. Release notes. Screenshots. My photos folder there. Let's get rid of that one. There you go. So super simple to get the apps on there. Now, you want to sort of enhance your workflow. Now, binding things to keys is the way forward with this. Now, one of the things is that it's got, like, if you just do a super K, it shows you all your key bindings. So you want to go in and you want to tweak these because they've done some defaults in here, but they're not what you want. I mean, if I do super D, it would launch Docker. Now, I think I don't really know what Docker is, to tell you the truth here. I know it's a thing that you put stuff in and you can run stuff, but it's no use to me in the creative world. I can't make pictures with it. So we need to modify. You can uninstall stuff as well. You can uninstall Docker, uninstall the bit. So this brilliant thing is a foundation to build on this Omarchy. So it's great. So, but let's just tweak the keys. Now, I've done this already for DaVinci Resolve, and I've removed Docker from the Super D key because it would be Super D Resolve. And here we go. So let's come out of that. Escape. Super D. Press them at the same time, Gav. Yeah. And up we've got Resolve comes up. That's on Super D. So let's just open the project. There we go. So, and as I said, you need to have done the previous video to get that on there. But let's edit the key bindings. So what you need to do is go Super F to bring up your file manager. Let's put that into the grid mode. Now, off the bat, it's going to look like this, which is great, but no use, because you need to go into the hidden folders to do this. So you go show hidden files. Now, I'm sure there's like a terminal way to do this. Very smart if you know where things are, but I don't know where things are. So then you go into config. And then in here, in hyper, there's bindings config. Now, there's a thing on here called Alacrity and NeoVim. I don't use those. The ones I've got used to is using a thing called Kate to do text editing. So right click on it, open with Kate, which I've installed from the package manager. Open, and over it comes. So in here, you can rebind keys. So a binding Super D, all I did was I changed it to DaVinci and then removed what was there and then just put Resolve hyphen NVIDIA hyphen open. Now this is based off my script. So that's literally all you need to do to do this. Then you'll just save it and you're done. And close that. So if I press Super D, up it comes. Now you can do that with any of your apps. So you just need to work out what you want to do on your super keys, what you use the most. Let's come out of that one. And then if you go Super K, because you've done it in there, you'll never forget it because you control down. So if I type D, Super D is now DaVinci. Now that's that little bit of text that's in the file. So you could do this with, you can see keys and things you don't want. You can repurpose them in that section for things you do want. So if you go down, you've got, what else have we got in here? So Super B's browser, Super C's calendar, switching workspaces. So I'm just gonna show you that's what that's something I hadn't clicked onto. This is the whole crux of this thing. So let's get rid of that. If you want to move between workspaces, so let's open something up in here. So Super B in this one for the browser. I want to go to the next workspace, it's Super 3. So that's the third one, because the first one, we'll go Super 2, back to the browser. Super 1, we're going to OBS. Hi, that's me. And then back to Super 2, Super 3. Really, really quick, because as I said in the other video, the programs don't minimize. So you basically just chop them into a new workspace and just move between them, which is way quicker than minimizing and expanding things. It's just like going super two, super three, and moving between them. It's much more fluid. So if I launch resolving this one, super D, up it comes. And then if I go, let's bring that up properly, and then go super four. And then in this one, I can have, I don't know, apps, GIMP. Let's open that up. There's a thing. Hello, cruel world. There you go. So if I now go, I want to go back to resolve, I'll go super three. And you just flip between these. It's brilliant. It's seamless. No more minimizing. I mean, I have such trouble on a Mac with this where it doesn't expand properly and I'm fiddling around and I'm moving things around. However, this does have a, if I do super F, I haven't tried this. Have I got a video file on here? Let's find a video file. Okay, so super F. I've got a video driver folder here. Let's just get that. Copy, and I'm going to go back up home. I haven't seen drag and drop's interesting on this. But let's put this into videos. Paste. There you go, it's copying to the bottom. That's a pretty quick way of doing that. Let's shut this. Well, let's not shut this. Let's try. There's my media pool. Let's see if I can drag the media into the media pool. Yes. Oh, that's sweet. So basically, and then if I shut this one down, super W, there's my clip. It's a bit of create new timeline. Create. Let's go into my timeline. There it is. Very bad footage that I shot in at Kew Gardens, Inspector. Stabilization, let's try that. Stabilize it. Oh, it's a bit better, isn't it? Give it some color. Let's just do it in, how do we just do something really super quick? So let's do color management. DaVinci color managed. I think that's iPhone 17 footage. Save. There's my color. Into that one. I wonder if Control F works. Control F. Oh, it does. There you go. So you're going to see. I know it's not keyboard orientated, but basically a lot of your it hasn't touched my resolve keys. That would have been a problem. So let's have a look at there. Full res camera data clip. Standard. Yeah. And then let's put it to whatever. White balance. There's my clip. Anyway, let's go back to the next one. Go in there and we'll make it zoom out. Rescale. Retiming. Scaling. Fill. There you go. And you're good to go. So let's close that. Super D. Which on super 4. Super close that. Super 2. Close that. You see how fluid that is to work in? That's nuts. Anyway, there you go. You have a blast. That's such a great OS to work in. As you can see in my other videos, I'm quite taken by this. It's just like a whole new way of doing things really quick. I know you can do key bindings on Windows and Mac, but it's the clarity of how this works. It's totally clear. There's nothing to distract me on the desktop. There's no desktop icons to make me click. There's no things. Everything is when I ask for it and when I need to see it, not have being rammed into my face all the time that it's there. Anyway, so there you go. That's Omarchy and Creative Tools. That's one of the simplest ones I've ever done for these, because sometimes it can be a real pain to get these things working. And that's really fluid. It's really good. Anyway, Super One, that's me. And I'll just stop recording. Thanks for watching.